Well, I would say that prior to having the experience of coming to Europe, my dad, of course, had his sound system, Rakkas International Sound System, for years, which is a part of where Gabriel Selassie was brought into the Rakkas camp. But I was familiar with Stepaz through that, because he had a lot of Jazz Shaka records, and of course, Twinkle Brothers, and he was a very wide, you know, musical listener, so he wasn't like, he just listened to Jamaican dub, or he was traveling to London from them times, so he was influenced and had played influence to that scene as well. So for me, coming to the UK last year for the first time, I really experienced like a Jazz Shaka session, or like Abashanti, for example, or Jatanda, Jayu, the ambassador. It was very eye-opening and awakening to see physically, of course, because when you see something live in person, it gives you a different feeling. So seeing it just reminded me of influence that has been there and that will always be there through the music, which has spread to places like London. Of course, in a place with a generation of Caribbean descendants and second generation, third generation by now. So it's like these people, some of them move back and forth through London, and the sound system culture was able to even take stronger grown in a place like London because of the fact that the technology, the equipment was more available, readily, you know, accessible, because in Jamaica there's only probably a few people that build that level of sound system. You know, in the back in the past days of Tubbies would build his own sound system and people like that. So it was very much creative, and you know, Sir Cox and God, Duke Reed and so on and so forth. So I think this transplant of culture has taken place from those times, the 60s, the 50s, and of course has grown to a high level this time, where you have man like Jazz Shaka still kind of strong, and the younger generations, his son as well, have an installed system. So it's a really good feeling to know that the music, we know that it will never die, but when they try to act as, even as earlier, people do say in Jamaica that dub is dead. I would say that a lot of people in Jamaica never really appreciated it because of, it's very intellectual, it's not something that's like, it's not a high thing. So it's really about a meditation, as I was saying earlier. So dub may not be for everyone, but at the same time, it does influence everyone, even if they don't, you know, realize it.
Any more questions from the panelists? Or
in the interest of time, we should open it up to question and answer with the audience, so that we allow you good people here to put your questions to these gentlemen here. So who would like to be the first to put their question? Do we have a question in the house for the Sons of Dawn?